Gautam the Buddha has given to the world the most psychological relation. It is incomparable. No other religion even comes closer to it. Its heights, its depths are tremendous. And the reason why a Buddha succeeded in giving such a beautiful vision of life is very simple. He did not believe. He inquired. He explored. He did not believe in the tradition. He did not believe in the scriptures. He did not believe in the priests. This was one of his fundamentals, that unless you know, you don't know. You can borrow knowledge, you can become knowledgeable, well informed, a scholar, a pundit, a professor, but you will not be a seer. Deep down, the ignorance will persist and will affect your life. Deep down, you will remain the same childish self, immature, ungrounded, uncentered, unintegrated. You will not be an individual. You won't have any authenticity. You will be pseudo, false, phony. It is a quantum leap into the unknown. When you don't believe in the tradition, when you don't believe in the scriptures, when you don't believe in anybody except your own experience, you are going into the unknown all alone. It needs guts. It needs courage. And only a courageous person can be truly religious. Cowards are there in the churches, in the temples, in the mosques, in millions. But they don't create any religious beauty, any religious fragrance in the world. They don't make the world more beautiful, more alive, more sensitive. They don't create anything. They only go on doing formalities, rituals. They themselves are dead. And they go on deceiving others. They themselves are deceived. Borrowed knowledge creates great deception. Because you start feeling as if you know. And that as if is a big as if. Truth liberates. Belief binds. Truth liberates because it has to be yours. It has to be an inner experience, an encounter with that which is. Buddha is a non-believer. He is not an atheist like Karl Marx or Friedrich Nietzsche. He is neither a theist like all the priests of all the religions. He is an agnostic. He neither believes nor disbelieves. He is open. That is his great gift to the world, to be open to truth. Go utterly naked, without any conclusions, without any ideology, any prejudice. Otherwise, there is every possibility that you will project your own idea. You will not see that which is, you will see only that which you want to see. You will be creating your own reality, which is bound to be false. Reality has not to be invented, it has to be discovered. It is already there. And remember, it is not the reality which is hidden. It is your eyes which are covered with layers of dust. Buddha gave to the world a non-metaphysical religion, a psychological religion. He simply helps you to go beyond mind. He helps you to understand the mind, because it is only through understanding that transcendence happens. But when I say that Buddha has given the most psychological religion to the world, don't misunderstand me. He has not given a psychology. He has given a psychological religion, which is a totally different phenomenon. He has not given a psychology like Sigmund Freud, Carl Gustav Jung, Adler, Pavlov, Skinner, etc. These people are confined to the mind. They think mind is all. There is nothing beyond the mind. So analyze the mind. If you have found the truth of the mind, you have found the truth according to them. That is beginning with a wrong attitude. Man is neither the body nor the mind. Man is the awareness within, which can look at the body, which can look at the mind, which is capable of witnessing all. You are the witness.